terminology, series parallel combinations, fine. So series X circuit elements, then their equations, their basic characteristics we discussed, voltage divider rule with that what we discussed, series parallel combination in each parallel circuits and their equations we discussed, parallel circuit characteristic discussed, current divider rule also discussed, fine. And few terminologies which we already discussed in detail, fine. Bilateral circuits, unilateral circuits, electrical network, passive network, active network, node, branch, loop, and mesh, fine. Then we discussed Kirchhoff's current law, fine. So let me quickly revisit the algebraic sum of currents meeting at a node or junction point in electrical circuit is zero. So here in this diagram, this is a junction, or we can consider as a node also. So current leaving the node, current leaving the junction, and current entering into the junction. So I1 and I4 are fine. Then you can write it with plus sign. Similarly, I4 is with plus sign and the remaining minus sign. And this way we can write the different equations. Okay. Now, let us proceed with Kirchhoff's voltage law. So that state that the algebraic sum of all the voltages in any closed path or mesh, fine, or loop of an electric circuit is zero. Fine. So summation of all the voltage that is equal to zero, and we know that the voltage is the product of resistance and current. So with respect to this voltage sources, again we can add some resistor where the current is flowing. So the product IR is also an I mean we can say it is a voltage. Fine. So the algebraic sum of the product of current and resistance of various branches of a closed path is in a circuit plus algebraic sum of EMFs. Fine. So this is also equally true, Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay. Then also I have given an example of Kirchhoff's current law and voltage law. Then we also discussed about the determination of sign, voltage sign, fine. So here this voltage sign of EMF, rise in voltage, that is to be considered as plus, fall in voltage, that is to be considered as minus. Similarly, for resistance, or we can say resistors connected, in which the direction of current, fine, because here it is plus and minus, so this is the direction of current. Here this is plus and this is minus, so the direction of current is there. So in that case, we can consider it as fall in voltage, and for this, we can consider it as rise in voltage. So let us have one example of it, and then you will understood that what is rise in voltage, what is fall in voltage. Okay.
Sir, can you show the previous slide, that orange diagram, yellow?
Which one?
The previous slide, sir.
Just a minute. This one.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Yeah, it is very simple for the understanding of Kirchhoff's current law. So this is Kirchhoff's current law. Here there is a node, fine. So current entering here, I2, and current I3 entering here, fine. So here we can write I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to zero, because all the three currents are entering. Suppose if one more current is there, I4, which is out of this node, fine. Then here we can write is equal to I4. Okay, so this is for an understanding of an example only. Fine. Similarly, here the Kirchhoff's voltage law. So here there are different voltages V1, V2, V8, V6, right? So how to write these equations for Kirchhoff's voltage law? It is mentioned here. Fine. Okay. Now this is regarding the voltage sign. Okay. Now for that, this is the best example which I would like to show here, and then we'll directly jump to star delta and delta star transformation. Fine. So here, one network is shown here, which contains E1 here, another E2 is here. Fine. Okay. Now, resistor R4, R1, R2, and R3 are connected together. Fine. And see here, three things are important to understand. First of all, the voltage source connected. So here E1 is connected, E2 is connected. Similarly, four different resistors are connected, R1, R2, R3, and R4. Fine. And the direction of current from each branch. So this is known as branch. Fine. So the current I1 is flowing in this direction. Okay. Similarly, the current is flowing in this direction from top to bottom, and current I3 is flowing from D to C, and current I4 is flowing from D to A. Fine. This is an example. Fine. So now here we can assume the direction in two different ways. Either we can assume the direction of travel in this way, and second, we can assume in this way. Fine. So it depends on the network. Right now it is a very simple network. Fine. But if there are some complex networks are there where number of meshes are more, in that case we have to assume certain directions with respect to the different networks. Fine. Okay. Now let us assume first of all the direction this way, and it is shown with an arrow. Fine. Okay. Now, first of all, we'll see the voltage sources here. Fine. Okay. Now, here this is a minus sign. Just I would like to change the color. Minus sign, and here it is a plus sign. Now, for this battery, here it is a plus sign, it is a minus sign. Okay. Now, first of all, I would like to show you that if there are two different batteries, 5 volt and 10 volt, are connected together, we can simply say it is a minus plus, it is a minus plus sign. So simply we can say the total voltage of this series combination is 5 plus 10, 15 volt. Okay. The same example, if I draw like this, 10 volt and 5 volt. Fine. So minus sign, plus sign, plus sign, and minus sign.
And minus 5.
Yeah. So here in this case, we can easily see that it is 10 minus 5. So 5 volt. Fine. Now here you can see the sign. Here it is a minus sign, here it is a plus sign. It means if the plus sign is connected to the minus sign of the another voltage battery source, fine. And another battery source like this, fine. Say for example, more 15 volt, then it is a summation, fine. So similarly here, you can see the direction of this battery and this battery. If you
so can see that. Here is 10 minus 5.
Where?
In the second one you showed.
Yes. Here, both the batteries are connected in the opposite directions. Fine. Here, minus sign is here, plus sign here, plus sign here, minus sign here. So 10 minus 5, 5 volt total of these two. Now here you can consider this is a 10 volt battery and this is a 5 volt battery. Fine. Just forget the resistors are not connected. Only two batteries are connected in the direction. Fine. So here, the direction of assumption is clockwise. So this is the direction of assumption. Fine. We can consider this is a rise in voltage. Fine. And similarly, here from this, it is minus to plus, so rise in voltage. It is plus to minus, so it is fall in voltage. Okay. Now, according to the diagram, here, see, rise in voltage. So this is the assumption of the direction. This is the assumption of the direction. But the terminals of batteries are reversed. So rise in voltage is considered as plus, fall in voltage is considered as minus in this figure. Fine, okay, first two figures. So in that condition, for this case, we can write E1 is considered as, or even maybe write as plus 10, because it is E1 is positive here. So that this is a rise in voltage, this is a fall in voltage. And here we can write minus 5 volt. Right? So if we write the Kirchhoff's voltage law, in that case, we have to write plus 10 volt. And for that case, we have to write minus 5 volt. Is it true? And I think it is very simple to understand. Similarly, if we assume the direction in this way, it means the current, the assumption of the direction is this way, fine. So this is minus, this is plus. So this is rise in voltage. And similarly for this case, this is plus and minus, and the assumption of the direction is from plus to minus. So it is fall in voltage. So if you assume this, then this will be a 10 volt and this will be 5 volt. But here rise in voltage, so we will consider it is a plus 5 volt, and here it is a minus 10 volt. So your answer will be minus 5. Fine. Ultimately, we are adding all this rise in voltages and fall in voltages and equating to zero. Fine. So here in this case, in the first case, now how to identify fall in voltage and rise in voltage for battery or voltage sources? Fine. Similarly, we'll go for resistance. Now this is the resistance. Okay. So current is flowing. Now consider the case number one. Fine. The current is flowing in this way. Fine. It means this is a plus terminal and this is a minus terminal. Okay. Now your assumption of the direction is this clockwise. Fine. So in that case, this is your direction of assumption. This is the direction of current. Okay. So direction of current and assumptions are same. So we can consider as fall in voltage. In this case, this is a rise in voltage, but in the case of resistance, it is fall in voltage. Fine. So, sir,
it depends on the direction of travel.
Yes, whatever the direction you assumed. Fine. Similarly, suppose if you assume the direction in this way, fine, and the current is in this way, because the current direction is shown here. Fine. It is fixed. We cannot change. It is shown here. Fine. And in many networks, we have to find out the direction of the current, because ultimately it is the voltage and resistances, and because of that, the current travels. Fine. So in this network, we do not know, but the direction of current I1, I2, I3 are mentioned. And according to that mentioned direction and our assumption of direction of travel, we may write rise in voltage and fall in voltage. Okay. So here we know that V is equal to IR. Normally we write this expression. Fine. So the total voltages, or we can also write V minus IR is equal to zero. So whenever there is a rise in voltage through an active element, then there is a fall in voltage at passive elements. So resistors are passive elements, sources are active elements. Okay, so this way we can also write. Okay, so let me write the all expression of all whole network. Fine. So the direction is this way. Okay. First of all, let us start with I1 R1. Okay. Now, before we proceed, here you can see. So the direction of current, positive and negative terminal. If the current is flowing in the reverse, then positive terminal and negative terminal. And this is the motion which we assumed. So direction of current and assumption of motion both are in the same direction, then the fall in voltage. And if it is in opposite direction, then rise in voltage. Fine. Okay. So this is the first case for I1 R1. Okay. Let us see. Here. So direction of current in this case is from left to right. Okay, and our assumption of the direction is same. So there is a fall in voltage. Okay, so here we can write I1 R1 with the minus sign, right? Because it is a fall in voltage. Similarly, here the current is flowing in this direction, and assumption is also in this direction, right? So there is
fall in voltage.
Yeah. So we can write an expression minus
I2 R2.
Here we can mention also fall in voltage. Fine. Okay. Now coming to the battery. This battery. Okay. So assumption of the direction is this way. This is plus and minus. Who can say for E2? E2 is
drop. Minus E2.
Minus E2 because it is fall in voltage. Fine. Minus E2. Fall in voltage. Okay. Similarly,
it's sir in E2 it's plus to minus.
Yes. Pardon?
In sir E2 it's plus to minus.
Yeah, plus to minus, and the direction is this. Fine. So that is a fall in voltage. Here in this case it is minus and plus.
Risen.
So this is the rise in voltage. Fine.
Rise in
so
voltage.
Okay. Let us complete one by one. So R1 is okay, R2 is now fine, E2 is okay. Now come to this part, I3 and R3, fine. So who can say, I mean, the direction of current is mentioned
opposite
here.
I3 R3.
Fine, fine.
Rise in voltage.
Correct. Here the direction is shown here, fine. Our assumption direction is in opposite. So
positive.
Opposite direction. So we can write plus
I3 R3,
rise in voltage. Correct. Similarly, we can write for E1 now. So E1 is plus E1, that is rise in voltage. Correct. And what about R4? The direction is upward of current. And assumption is
minus I4 or
fallen voltage.
Same direction. So we can write an expression I4
minus I4
R4.
R4 minus I4 R4.
That is fallen voltage.
Fallen voltage.
Okay. Now, the similar case, if we assume the direction reversed anticlockwise like this. What is going to happen now with all these parameters?
This will be opposite signs.
Yes, correct. Opposite sign. Fine. So ultimately, what is Kirchhoff's voltage law says that the summation of all this
is equal EMFs, to zero. Is equal to
EMF
zero.
And this EMF and this product of I and R, fine, is equal to zero. So we can write minus I1 R1. Just I would like to change the color. Okay, minus I1 R1 minus I2 R2 minus E2 plus I3 R3 plus E1 minus I4 R4 is equal to zero. Fine. Now here, the minus terms equal to plus terms that you can equate. Yes or no? Fine. Now, if you assume the direction in the reverse case, then we can also write plus I1 R1 plus I2 R2 plus E2 minus I3 R3 minus E1 plus.
But I4. Sir, in that case also it will be zero only.
Yeah, is equal to zero. Ultimately, you will get the same answer in both the cases. So if you by mistake or if you assume the direction, fine, or the direction of travel is in the reversed, Kirchhoff's voltage law will give you the same results. Is that clear now, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So shall we move to star delta transformation now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Ciao. Thank you. So star delta and delta star transformation. Now, here this kind of an arrangement is known as delta connection, right? So this is delta. So in delta, suppose if there is a terminal number 1, terminal number 2 and terminal number 3, so there is a network in which this kind of an arrangement shown or exist, then such kind of arrangement is known as delta arrangement. And here it is a kind of star connection. Star connection. Fine. So terminal number 1, terminal number 2, and terminal number 3. Okay. So if you have a network like this, fine. Suppose this is terminal number 1, 2, 3, and 4. And if the resistors are given like this, different resistor values are given, fine. And if you want to solve, you can solve either by converting delta to star and star to delta, fine. Suppose if, let us consider this is the, this one is the delta, 1, 2, 3 is the delta, fine. Now this delta, if I convert into star, then star will be looking like this. Because there are three terminals, 1, 2, and 3, 1, 2, and 3 terminals, and we can convert this value of delta to star like this. Fine. Terminals remain same, 1, 2, and 3, and the resistors between these two, fine, will be considered as R1. Between these two will be considered as R2. And between these two will be considered as R3. So R1, R2 and R3 resistors are of star connection. Of star connection. Similarly, R1, 2, because in delta, all these terminals are connected with a common terminal. Fine. So here it is a common terminal between 1 and 2. So this is the resistor known as R12, because it is connected between 1 and 2. Similarly, connected between 2 and 3, so R23, fine, and R31. So here in this particular case, we can remove this delta like this, and we can find and we can connect this resistor and this resistor. Now here you can see all these four resistors are in series now, fine, and this is again in series. So this way we can solve and we can reduce the complexity of transformation by transforming delta to star and star to delta. Now let us see how to convert this, fine. Okay, so there is a expression which we are going to derive. Suppose if you want to convert from delta to star, then we will draw a star like this, fine. So terminals are same again, fine. Now let me start. Okay, so this is a notepad, okay. Okay, so first of all, let us have a theory, that is delta to star transformation. Delta to star transformation. Okay. So first of all, let us draw a delta connection. You may also write in your notebook, fine. So this is terminal number 2 and this is terminal number 3. Okay, now instead of 1, 2, 3, we can write ABC also, fine. A, B and C also. Okay, so in delta, this is A, this one is B, and this one is C. So here we can write R AB because it is in between A and B. If it is one here, then we can write, and if it is two here, then we can write R 1 2. Why I'm just showing you this one? Because in the different books, they have noted with 1 2 and AB. Fine. So there is no confusion created. Okay. Similarly, we can write the resistance between these two is R BC. And similarly here, R CA. Is it? Now we are converting this into star. So star is like this. Or we can draw the diagrams like this. So this is terminal A, this is terminal we can say B, and this is terminal we can say C. Fine. So A here we can consider as RA. This is connected to B, so we can consider it as RB and RC. Okay. So we are converting the different resistance of RAB, RBC, RCA into RA, RB, and RC. Fine. So let us write the different equations. Okay. First of all, looking at the figure, sorry. Looking at the figure, fine. Okay. Now, can we write the resistance between terminal A and B, between the terminal A and B? So this is terminal A, this is terminal B, or you can write capital A, capital B, and C. Fine. Notation may be given any, like 1 2 3, or capital A, capital B, capital C, or small letters of ABC. Okay. So here, if you use capital letters, then you have to write capital A. So what is the resistance between terminal A and B here? So just forgot that there is no C terminal here, because here this is a node, or we can say junction.
Fine. RAB?
Yeah, RAB parallel to this one. So we can write RAB parallel to, now these two resistors are connected in series, because suppose if the C is not there, fine, because we consider the resistance between terminal A and B only. So
then RC and RBC will be parallel to each other.
Yes.
And so then the resultant of RC and RBC will be parallel to RAB.
Plus RCA. Clear? So RBC and RCA is parallel to RAB. Fine. So this is the node. This is the node. And
sir, how is it parallel to RAB?
Just a minute. Now just remove this one. Okay. Now C terminal is not there. Now you see here in this case, what is the resistance between terminal A and B? So this is terminal A, this is terminal B. This is terminal A, fine. So this is terminal A, this is terminal B. Okay, so here you can consider like this. Now if you solve, or if you write again, this is terminal A, this is terminal B. So between A and B, there is one resistor. Which one? RAB.
RAB.
Okay. And again, one more resistor, which are connected in series, it looks like connected in series, are parallel to this RAB. Fine. So here we can say there are more two resistors, 1 and 2, are connected in series here. Which are they? RCA and
RBC.
Fine. So can we write
but
like
sir,
this?
But sir, in this delta, how can we say that? like they don't look
now, now we are trying to convert from delta to star. Fine. So in the first case, suppose if you want to find out the resistance between terminal A and B, forget that there is no C terminal. Fine. In that case, we can write such kind of an equation. Yes or no? We can write this equation. Yes or no? Yes.
Yes, sir.
We can write. Fine. Okay. So similarly, if we consider the another terminals and then we can write the expression. Yes or no? Okay. Actually, we are trying to convert these values of RAB, RCA and RBC into these different values. Which are they? They are RA, RB and RC, which are of star connection. Fine. So here there are resistors. Fine. And for that reason, we are assuming that the C terminal is not there. Then what is the resistance between A and B? Fine. So this is the value. And we can write an expression for this. Yes or no? As per the rule, RAB into RBC plus RCA upon, yeah, this is parallel circuit, fine. So we can write the equation of parallel circuit directly. Yes or no? RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Clear? Can we write? Yes, we can write this expression. Now, similarly, resistance between the terminal B and C. Okay. Who will speak the equation between these two?
Sir, RCB is parallel
yes,
to
yes, yes.
RCB yes, is parallel from, to RAB yes. plus RCA.
Okay, RBC.
Sir, can you explain this second last step? RAB into RBC plus RCA.
This one. My dear.
Achha, that is the resultant of parallel, right? Okay. Got it.
R1 plus 1 upon R2. So we can write 1 upon R is equal to. Fine. And if we convert it to R, then the equation becomes R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. This one. Yes or no? Very simple.
Got it.
Okay, fine. Okay, so similarly, here we can write an expression RBC parallel to RCA plus
RAB.
Correct. And from this, we can derive this expression also. So, equation becomes RBC into RCA plus RAB upon RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Fine. So this is equation number two. And similarly, resistance between the terminal C and A. Yes or no? Yeah. So it will become RCA into RAB plus RBC.
So matlab in this transformation of from star to delta, hum har ek terminal ko alternately bhul jata hai and then resultant
is then correct. Then we can write that kind of an expressions. Fine.
Okay, equivalent resultant. Okay, sir.
Okay. So very simple trick to remember. Suppose here there are terminal A and B, terminal A and B, fine. So in this case, first of all, we'll write this expression directly, this one, fine. So RAB, fine. Then AB, B ke baad C aayega, so BC, C ke baad A aayega, to CA, like this. and then ultimately it is RAB, BC and CA addition.
So sir, it's kind of cyclic.
Cyclic, yes, yes, yes. And similarly for BC here, say for that I have started RBC, then CK bar A aega, to CA, fine. It is looking like that, A, B and C, fine, like this. So always you consider in this way. Okay, and you can write the three equations directly in the examination if it is asked. Yes or fine. So RBC. So between B and C, we can write RBC, CA, and then AB. And then finally, ultimately, the summation. And similarly, in between C and A, it is written like this. Yes or no? So I think this is very simple to understand. So there are three different equations we derive. Okay. Okay. Now, from these three different equations, we can write and we can try to find out RA, RB and RC. How? Let us see. Okay. Now, first of all, subtract these three different equations from either side. Fine. So here, this is equation number one. In the different books, if you go, this will be given as number one, this will be given as number two, and similarly, this will be given number three, this will be given as number four.
Sir, sorry to interrupt, but sir, will you be sending this PDF or shall we take the screenshot of this?
Yes. Now onwards, I will give you this video recording to each and every student.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Fine, fine. But try to understand. Fine, right now. Very simple to understand. I am not just giving you any complex calculations and all. These are very simple things. Okay. So here, there are five or six different equations are written in the book. And that's why I have mentioned here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Because in the book, it is mentioned like this. Okay. So you should not confused after reading the book. Okay.
So sir, this is for the delta to star.
Yeah, we are trying to convert from delta to star. Correct? Okay. So what exactly we are doing now? Now, what we are going to do is we are going to convert all these different values. Fine. Okay. Do you get this kind of an equations? Okay. Now, similarly, we can write the expressions of delta also between terminal A and between terminal B. Okay, fine. So let me first of all remove this one. Okay. Now, even I can share this PDF also. This is a specifically a notepad. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Okay, so these are the equations we have written for delta connection. Similarly, we can write for star, yes or no? Yes, we can write. We can write for star connection also. Okay. Now, let us see. Okay. So here in this figure, I have shown star and delta, fine. So now consider the resistance between terminal A and B, and then we derive this equation for delta. Similarly, we can derive an expression for star also. Okay. What is the resistance between terminal A and B of star by removing the third one? So just remove
RA plus RB.
RA plus RB,
correct. So here we can also write, this is expression number one, and for delta, we can write resistance between the terminal A and B is equal to RA plus RB, and we can give this equation number two. Fine. In the book of Professor UA Patel, fine, it is mentioned like this, one and two. Similarly, we can write an expression for, this expression is for delta, and we can write for star. Fine. So what is an expression here for star? It is RB plus RC.
RB plus RC.
And similarly for the third case, this is for delta, and what is the expression? That is
RC plus RA.
C plus RA. Okay, and similarly, you can give the different name of the equations. Okay, now as per the definition, whatever the resistance between terminal A and B is always equal, either it is RARB or whether it is RAB and RCA or RBC. Fine. So in the first case, this resistance, which resistance? By considering delta RAB into RBC plus RCA upon RAB plus RBC plus RCA is exactly equal to RA plus RB. Yes or no? Because
Yes, sir.
This is also a resistance between terminal A and B, and this is also a resistance between terminal A and B. So can we write an expression? Can we write an expression? RA plus RB is equal to,
right, basically,
RB into RBC plus RCA upon RAB plus RBC plus,
yes, sir, plus RCA.
Yes or no? We can write. Okay. So we can give the number accordingly. Okay. So all of you, I just request, write down all these three different equations in your notebook. Fast.
Sir, you will get the recording of this class, right?
Yes. Sir, so we can subtract 2 from 1 and find RA minus RC and then RA plus RC from third one. So we'll get RA from that.
Yes. That's what we are doing. Fine. Now, similarly, we'll write RB plus RC. Yes or no? So RBC into RC. CA plus
RAB
upon RAB
plus
RBC plus RCA. So equation number 3, 4, you can give accordingly. Fine. And similarly, we can write for RC plus RA. Okay. So RCA. So very simple way to remember that if it is A and B, simply we can write RAB here. Okay, and then cyclic equations can be written. Fine. So RCA multiplied by RAB plus RBC upon RAB
plus RBC
plus and RCA.
Plus RCA.
Fine. This is CA. Okay. Equation number. Or if it is 1, 2, 3, then it is 4, 5, 6. Fine. So I am not concerned about this number of equations, but yes. Now, what exactly we are doing? So if I want to find out RA, okay. If I want to find out RA here, or if I want to find out RB here, fine. With the help of these equations, we'll subtract from each other. We'll subtract from each other. Fine. So, okay. So let us consider equation number 4 and 5. Okay. 4 and 5. Okay. So if we subtract this equation from this equation, then we can get another expression. Okay. Kya hoga? RA plus RB minus RB plus RC. So minus RB and plus RB will be cancelled each other. Fine. Yes or no? Okay. So we are subtracting equation 4 and 5, right? So RA plus RB minus RC. Yes or no? Yes.
RA minus RC will be there.
Yeah. So this will be cancelled. Fine. So RA minus RC is equal to. अब इक्वेशन में क्या होगा? RAB RBC plus RCA upon RAB plus RBC plus RCA minus this equation. Fine. So RCA RAB plus RBC upon RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Okay. And from this, again, we can find out one more equation. Fine. So let us resolve this. So RAB into RBC plus RAB into RCA minus RCA into RAB minus RCA into RBC. Fine. And finally, what is the denominator? RAB plus RBC plus RCA.
RCA.
Is it? Now here there are few terms. This term RAB and CA. AB and CA will be cancelled. Fine. So final answer will be RAB into RBC minus RCA into RBC. Fine. And upon RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Yes or no? Okay. And this is equal to what? RA minus RC. RA minus RC.
So we can take RBC common.
Yes, yes, yes. That we can take RBC common from this. But see, we are getting this expression here. RA and C. Fine. Now, we are going to have another equation. Fine. And that is what? By adding equation number 5 and this one. Aapka jo agla equation tha. Which one? The third one. Third one kaun sa hai? RC and RA. RC and RA. This is the third equation. So if we add these two, RC, RA, and RA, RC. Fine. So
there we will get two RA.
You will get two RA.
Huh.
Fine.
So and RC will be cancelled.
Yeah. You can consider this equation number 7. Fine. Ab kya kar rahe hain hum log? Ye wala jo equation hai, RC plus RA. Okay. उसका इक्वेशन हम लिख देते हैं RC plus RA. हाँ, उसको हम ऐड कर रहे हैं किसके साथ? इसके साथ plus RA minus RC. फाइन. तो इसका इक्वेशन तो मुझे पता है, ये तो हम सीधा लिख सकते हैं RAB into RBC minus RCA into RBC and upon RAB plus RBC plus RCA plus उसका भी इक्वेशन है. कौन सा इक्वेशन है? दिस वन. आर सी ए इंटू इंटू आर सी ए. सो आई विल राइट इट हियर. फाइन. आर सी ए इंटू आर ए बी प्लस आर बी सी अपॉन आर ए बी प्लस आर बी सी प्लस आर सी ए. यस ऑर नो? एंड फ्रॉम दिस वी नो दैट this RC, RC will be cancelled. So 2RA will be, if you solve this expression again, because the denominator is same, fine. So after adding these two, you will get the expression of RA, that is equal to, or we can say, if you remove these two also, RA equal to, you will get RAB into R CA upon RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Fine. So this is an expression of RA. This is an expression of RA. Fine. So if you solve this, then you will get the equation of RA is equal to. So see here, remember how to remember this equation. If it is RA, it will start from RAB into A, B, C, A, sequence that you have to maintain, cyclic equation, fine. So RAB into RCA and upon RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Similarly, if you want to find out RB, you can write an expression of RB directly. Yes or no? RBC into RAB, BC, AB, like this, fine. You have to maintain this ABC, fine. So if it is B, then C, then if it is C, then it is AB, fine. So this way you have to maintain, and it is RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Fine. So if you know this RAB, RBC and RCA, you can directly write an expression of RB. Similarly, RC, RCA into RBC upon RAB, AB plus RBC plus RCA. Fine. So this way you can convert RA, RB and RC. So from these notations, RB, BC, AB are notation of delta, and RA, RB and RC are notation of star connection. Fine. So this way you can convert your delta parameters into star parameters. Fine. In the next lecture, we will again find out the inverse transformation. Inverse transformation from RA, RB, RC to RBC, RCA and RAB. Fine. I hope you enjoyed that lecture today.
But sir,
yes.
Sir,
yes.
In denominator, it won't come like 2RAB, 2RAB plus.
You please solve this one. This is
sir, from 2RA. Sir, from 2RA, if we just want to find RA.
Yeah. This 2 will be cancelled. Here also, there will be a 2. Fine. Suppose, simply just add. See, R here it is. RBC prime and RCA. Okay. Now here there are this term will be cancelled. This term CA wala A cancel ho jayega apka term. Either and A kaun sa hoga RCA RAB. Fine. A wala ek term cancel ho jayega. Fir jo bacha aapka term. Kaun sa term bachega? RCA and RAB wala term bachega. And yahan pe par ek time bachega. To yahan pe multiplication mein 2 aa jayega aur 2 will be cancelled ho jayega. Aap ek bar solve karke dekhiye fir ho jayega. No issue.
Okay, sir.
Fine. Okay. So I hope you enjoyed this lecture today, and we'll continue from star to delta transformation in the next session. Fine. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Okay. Now you may leave that meeting because you have more lectures today. Fine. At 4:10. Now it is 4:07. Fine. So after 3 minutes, the next session will be started. So, fine. Thank you.